No pictures, please. We have 10 in the sanctuary. Keep the line moving, please. No pictures, please. No photographs, please, and keep the line moving, please. Keep the line moving, please. We got 10 in the sanctuary. Five people in the sanctuary. Five people in the sanctuary.
Send four more into the sanctuary. Good afternoon, folks. No pictures, please. Live streaming in a little bit more. page. We can receive four more in the sanctuary. No pictures, please. Welcome to the Thomas Stokes Celebration of Life viewing. 9 in the sanctuary.
sanctuary, you can send in three. You can send in 10. You can send it. You can let 10 come in. And send in 5 more. You can send in 9, send in 9. Facebook page. Thank you. Thank you. Page.
Very Facebook page. You can send in three. Come in. Thing.
No photographs.
No photographs, the Stokes Thomas Visitation Celebration. Appreciate you all wearing your mask. It's a life-saving thing. Forward, please keep the line moving if you can. Please keep the line moving. Welcome to the Stokes Thomas Visitation Celebration. Oh, no pictures, please. Oh,
took my father. You came back and got my mother. You took everything to me.
You can send in three people at the... You can send in 10 people.
moving, guys. Thank you.
Keep it moving.
You can send in 10 people. Welcome to the Stokes Thomas Visitation Celebration. No pictures, please. The family appreciates your presence here today. Please keep the line moving as you come forward. You can send in 10, Sean. Good afternoon and welcome to the Stokes Thomas Visitation Celebration. No pictures, please. Keep the line moving as you come forward. I know the family appreciates you being here today. Appreciate you all wearing your masks. It's a life-saving thing we're doing. And send in three people. Good afternoon and welcome to the Stokes Thomas Visitation Celebration. No pictures, please. Please keep the line moving as you come forward. Thank you very much. The family appreciates your being here today. Welcome to the Stokes Thomas Visitation Celebration. No pictures, please. The family appreciates you being here today. Please keep the line moving forward. Keep the line moving, please. Please keep the line moving, please. You can send in 10 people. You can send in 10 people. Welcome to the Stokes Thomas Visitation Celebration. No pictures, please. The family appreciates you being here today. Please keep the line moving as you all move forward. The family appreciates you being here today. No pictures, please. Welcome to the Stokes Thomas Visitation Celebration. No pictures, please. We are live streaming on the New Pitch Mortuary's Facebook page. The family appreciates you being here today. Thank you. Welcome to the Stokes Thomas Visitation Celebration. The family appreciates you being here today. Please keep the line moving forward as you come forward. No pictures, please. Thank you. You can add 5 people into the sanctuary. Welcome to the Stokes Thomas Visitation Celebration. The family appreciates you being here today. Please keep the line moving forward as you come forward. We appreciate you all wearing your mask. That's a life-changing and a life-saving thing we're doing. Please keep the line moving. Can you all space yourselves in the pews? Don't sit tight, close together. Please put some space between yourselves. No pictures, please. Welcome to the Stokes Thomas Family Visitation Celebration. No pictures, please. You're welcome to the Stokes Thomas Visitation Celebration. No pictures, please. The family appreciates you being here today.
Jesus, I love her. I love her.
We welcome you all to the Stokes Thomas Visitation Celebration. No pictures, please. Keep the line moving as we move forward. Please, we're doing this live on the New Pitch Mortuary's Facebook page. You all don't use the center aisle, please. Don't use the center aisle. Go to the outer aisle. Thank you.
Thank you.
Keep the line moving, please.
Sometimes
I say, and we just want to again thank God for the Stokes family, the Thomas family. We just praise God. First thing on our list, we read it from Psalms 93. It reads, "The Lord reigns. He is clothed with majesty. The Lord is clothed with strength. Wherewith he has girded himself, the world also is established, that it cannot be moved. The throne is established of old. You are from everlasting. The floods have lifted up, O Lord. The flood have lifted up their voices. The flood lifted up their waves. The Lord on high is mightier than the noise of many waters. Yes, than the mighty waters of the sea. Thy testimony are very sure. Holiness becomes thine house, O Lord, forever." Psalms 93. In the scripture of the New Testament, John, the revelator, wrote to us some encouraging words to our family. It says, chapter 14, verse 1, "Let not your hearts be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would not have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And whether I go, you know, and the way you know." Thomas said unto him, "Lord, we know not where you go, and how can we know the way?" Jesus said unto him, "I am the way, the truth, the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. You have known me. You should have known my Father also. From now on, you know him and have seen him." I read you from the book of John 14, chapter verse 1 through 7. May God bless the reading of his holy word. Prayer. Father, we just want to pause for a moment to say thank you. Thank you, God. Because, God, we don't know no other, nothing else to do but to say thank you. This boggles our minds. We cannot comprehend. But, God, you are sovereign in all that you do, Lord. As we come now to lift up these two families to you, Lord, we lift them up, God, because you are only the one can give rest, peace to a troubled mind. God, we thank you, Lord, and we praise you. We just want to ask you, God, enter into their minds, enter into their thoughts. Let them know who you are, and let them know, God, that the secret things belong to you. And that which is revealed, it is for us. Those truths that you write to us in your word, to let you know that the earth is yours, and the fullness thereof, and they that dwell therein. Thank you, Lord, for letting us represent you at this period and at this time. We pray in the name of Jesus for my son in the ministry, Brother Stokes, Minister Stokes. Getting ready, God, to share the good news. Getting ready, God, to give out the gospel of Jesus Christ. God, we pray now that you begin to move on the altars of his heart. Father, we're going to give you praise. Those that are wounded, those that are hurting, those that don't understand, we're trusting you with them, Lord. Lord God, up and down the street on the outside, in the parking lot, all up and down. Lord, in the name of Jesus, that those that got to go back to the home, God, we're asking, God, that you will be in the midst, God. Move by your power, and we're going to praise you for it. We know you're going to do it because that's who you are. You're always looking for someone in order to encourage, in order to lift up, God. Lord, I pray that those that don't know you, God, will you bring them to a saving faith, Lord God, that they might get to know you and your power and your might, God. We praise you, oh God, for the fuel home, the pit, oh God, fuel home today. Thank you, Lord, and praise your name. Be with my brother. Empower him. Give him the strength, God, to do it for your glory. And we're going to praise you. And we're going to thank you. Bless, bless, bless in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. It's a few of us, but the scripture says when there are two or three that come together, it says he is in the midst. So let's give God a hand clap of praise on this day, because we came to celebrate these lives of the ones we truly love.
Yeah.
Even though this is a sad occasion, we ought to be glad. We ought to be able to smile because they go to a place where we all are still working to get to. I won't be long, and we heard this scripture, but I'm going to be coming from John 14, and it says, let not your heart be troubled. And I'm going to stop right there. Let not your heart be troubled. Right now, we hurting. We all know what a bad breakup feels like. We find ourselves not wanting to eat. We find ourselves not wanting to do anything. But when you lose a loved one, it's another type of hurt. We find ourselves in trouble. We find ourselves asking God questions. Why did this happen? How did you allow this to happen? But the scripture tells us that he is the I am. That he is a great God and he makes no mistakes. And so we here today to celebrate these lives. Even though our heart may be hurting, it's all right to cry. The scripture tells us weeping may endure for a night. Oh, we don't weep more than a night. Oh, a lot of us have been weeping since last Monday. But the scripture tells us joy will come in the morning. Now, all the time when we see trouble, every time a storm may come in our life. And we know when the storm comes, the dark clouds come in. The rain start coming down, but it don't last always. And usually after a storm, you'll see the sun peek behind the cloud. I come here to tell you there is some sunshine on the other side. But this scripture tells us, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God. All of us believe in God.
Come on.
He said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. He said, I'll be your burden bearer. I'll be your heavy load sheriff. What does that mean, preacher? He means come to me. You don't have to carry this by yourself. It's all right to cry. It's all right to yell. It's all right to scream. But he said, don't be troubled. You believe in me. And he said, in my Father's house. I'm in your mansions. If not, I would have told you. Oh, I come here today to let you know that Marcus, Daddy, T, T Tierra, Nene, God said, my children, you've been on earth too long. He said, I already got your mansions ready for you. Some of us down here trying to find new houses. Some of us down here trying to find these nice houses that we struggling to keep up with the ones we have. But God said, come on, my children. I already got your mansions prepared for you. We don't need to question why they went the way they went. But God said it was time. The scripture tells us no man knows the day nor the hour. We didn't know Monday they all would take their last breath.
Come on, please.
If we knew, we would have prepared for it. But God don't work like that. He worked in mysterious ways. He worked in ways to get our attention. The world is in trouble, y'all.
Come on.
The world is in trouble. We got the leaders in the White House don't know what they're doing. We got our governors in each state don't know what they're doing. And then we're losing loved ones and we can't get them the celebration that they deserve because of what's going on in the world. But you got to think everything that's going on, God planned for this to happen. Only God can close the church. Only God can close Wall Street. Only God can shut down the government. Only God can shut down everything on this earth. Why? So he can get our attention. But he said, I go to prepare a place. Oh, I can vision their mansions right now. I know they up there dancing. Because every last one of them always had a smile on their face. They never meant anybody in a hurt. Yeah, we may cry today, but we all smile. Because every time we see Marcus or any one of them, they put a smile on our face. Now, one time did they make us mad. They, you know, they might rub us the wrong way and irritate us, but they never meant any harm. No. They was caring. They always had a smile. They always kept the spirit up, no matter what the situation was. So why should we be sad? Yeah, we can weep because we're going to miss them. But God said, they're in a better place, y'all. He said the situation may look bad, but he said, just keep on living. Just keep on trusting in me. And everything will be all right. He said, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, ye may be also. And where I go, ye know. In a way, you know. God said, I go to prepare a place. The day when the doctor said it was a boy, it's a girl. The clock began to tick. God said, I gotta start building a mansion. He said, because time is running out. All of us are different in age. God has no respect of person. So he said, I got to come back and receive you unto myself. And Thomas said, Lord, we know whether or not thou goes. How can we know the way? And Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man come unto the Father but by me. I come here today to let you know, if you ain't got Jesus in your life, you better get you some Jesus. I come here to let you know that the only way we'll be able to see him again is if we go through his son. And if we go through the son, he said we can get to the Father. I come to let you know not every day will be peaches and cream, but all hell might break loose in your life. There'll be some trials. There'll be some tribulations. There'll be some suffering. But God, I come to let you know, it's a hard time for us. But when I think about the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, my soul cries out hallelujah. Because when I think about Jesus, I think about him on Calvary, how they nailed him to the cross.
How they stretch his arms out wide. Place the crown of thorns on his head. Oh, but it didn't stop there. He said, I thirst, and they gave him vinegar. Oh, but Jesus could have got down. But he stayed there all night long. Oh, he bled for you and I. But I come here today to let you know that death thought he had him. They took him down from the cross. They placed him in a borrowed tomb. But 3 days later, the scripture says early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hands. What are you trying to say, preacher? Jesus suffered for us.
Yeah.
And the only way to get to him, mm-hmm. we have to suffer for him. Mm-hmm. So family, I want to encourage y'all today. It's going to hurt. We have questions why. But I don't want you to leave today and doubt God. Yeah. I don't want you to do that. Because God makes no mistakes. Even though he took 5 loved ones away from us. Look at the age difference. He has no respect to person. God said, I can call you anytime. The devil is busy out. Mm-hmm. The devil is out to kill, steal, and destroy.
Yeah.
And the only way to fight the devil is you put on the whole armor of God.
Yeah.
So I come here today to let you know, be encouraged. Find a church home. Mm-hmm. Not for the name, but somewhere that you can get the word of God. Because one day we all got to be here.
Yeah, yeah.
We got to take the same path.
Yeah, yeah.
Our GPS going to run out. Mm-hmm. And we're going to be rolled in. Mm-hmm. Just like this. But we still got time to make a decision. Are we going to heaven? Or are we going to hell? The preachers can't put you there. Mom and daddy can't put you there. Your grandparents can't put you there. So let's be encouraged on today. Yeah, it's all right to cry. It's all right to be upset. But in due season, the scripture says joy comes. It comes in the morning. Amen? Let us pray. Eternal God, we come to you right now, Lord, just thanking you once again for these 5 lives. We thank you, Lord, for the borrowed time that you have given to us. Oh, God, we ask. Trumpets sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise, mm-hmm. and those of us alive will be caught up. Yes. So we ask, Lord, that you will continue to cover us.
Yes.
Continue to cover the Stokes and the Thomas family, God. Continue to strengthen them, God.
Yes.
Oh, Lord, we ask, Lord, that you will just have your way, God. Let us take this, God, and not be discouraged by God, but still trust in you and know that everything is going to be all right. Lord, we thank you. And we praise you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. At this time, we're going to be in the hands of the funeral directors.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You all who heard the preaching of the word of God, thank you, Minister Stokes, for a powerful message. For a period of time, we thank you. Anyone here that don't know Jesus is simply all you got to do. All you got to do is just ask the Lord, say, Lord Jesus, I believe that you died for me. Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. Lord Jesus, I believe that you died and rose again. Jesus, save me from my sins. The Bible says in Romans 10 and 13, wherefore whosoever call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Praise the Lord. If you will pray that prayer, the Lord will save you right now. And if you will die the next second, you will wind up in the presence of the Lord. Let's go stand right here. I'm reading from Genesis, the third chapter, starting at verse 18. Genesis chapter 3, verse 18. Thorns also and thistles shall it bring forth from for you, and you shall eat herbs of the field. In the sweat of your face you shall eat bread until you return unto the ground. For out of it you are taken. Dust to dust. Dust to dust and ashes to ashes you shall return. Father, we thank you and we praise you for this grand opportunity that you've given us to share in this time. We pray now that you will bless the family. And God, you said in your word that you called and they, sisters and brothers, return back to your presence. So, Father, we thank you now, and we praise you. We pray this prayer in your Son Jesus' name, and everybody says, amen. Amen. Everybody says, amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen. We want to say on behalf of Miss Michelle Pitts Luckett, along with her husband, Mr. Nate Luckett, and the entire staff of the New Pitts Mortuary, we want to say thank you, amen, to Pastor Stokes, Reverend Stokes, and your assistant for officiating this service. I know it was difficult for you to do that today because this is your family.
Amen.
So we thank God for you. Thank God for the other family members. We want to say thank you for allowing us to serve you during this most difficult and sacred time in your life. This is more than a job to us. It's more than a business. It's a ministry. So our sincere prayer is that in some small manner, something that may have been said or something that has been done has served to make these past several days just a little bit brighter. And prayerfully, your burden has been made just a little bit lighter. Amen. And of course, we would have all of you to know we are here. When you find yourself confronted with the loss of a loved one, family member, or friend, you don't have to hesitate to call us because we are here, the New Pitts Mortuary, and we are dedicated to serving all of the people of our community. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we say thank you. At this time, we're going to prepare to make our exit. We're going to call for five people to assist with the casket spreads at this time.
Thank you.
Lord, you have been our dwelling place out through the years. Lord, you have been our covenant from generation to generation. Lord, thou God, and God alone, under shadow of our wings, Lord, we have. The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord, I shall not want. He makes me to lay down in green pasture. Although I walk in the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table and the presence of my enemy. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of our life. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord. Okay, done. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? When my enemy come upon me, they stumble and fail. Though a host and captain, this will become in the Lord. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me, Jesus. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. If not so, I would not have told you. Away to prepare a place for you. And if I go away, I will receive you unto myself. I will come with a shout from the heavens. Those that are dead in Christ will rise first. They who are alive shall be caught up in the air and forever be with the Lord. With the Lord. Jesus says, I'm going back to my Father. I'm sitting on the right hand side. Jesus says, you can trust for me to come get you. Praise the Lord. Lord, thank you. Thank your people, Lord. Thank you, God. Lord, I praise your name. Lord, I ask you, Lord, cover them under the blood of Jesus. Cover them, protect them, Lord. Let them hear your voice. Your voice, God, that comes and soothes all our sorrows. Lord, bless now. Encourage now. Give insight, Lord. God, thank you. God, we praise you. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we see you working. We see you moving. With faith and admiration for what you're doing in front of your people. We just thank you and we praise you. God, we love you today. God, we thank you today. God, nobody knows but you. You know all our sorrows, God. You know all our heartaches, you know all our pain. We just said, Lord, thank you for being with us, Lord. For quiet. Thank you for strengthening your people, God. We praise your holy and righteous name. Continue, Lord Jesus. Do it for your glory, God. We're going to honor you, and we're going to bless you. Jesus. Jesus. It's you, Jesus. 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 I'm going back in something. Okay. Something put the last chance. Thank you, Jesus. Well done. Done, boy. Well done. All right, brother.